The foundation stone of the Carmo convent in Lisbon was set on July 1389 by order of the constable Nuno Álvares Pereira, who lived here as a friar for the last 8 years of his life. Back then in Lisbon, only two monuments were comparable to this church in their dimension, the Lisbon Cathedral and the convent of St. Francis, later destroyed. Its location on top of the Chagas Hill gave it a preponderance in the city's landscape that would only be surpassed by the São Jorge Castle. The church was built following the Gothic style patterns, featuring a main portal in pointed arch with six archivolts and columns with phytomorphic capitals. The bottom and top of the beveled spaces between the columns, as well as the capitals, are decorated with small human heads. It was directly above this portal that the rose window that illuminated the church's choir, now destroyed, was located. The location chosen for this construction stood on a steep slope with an unstable sandy soil, making it a very unfavorable place for a project of this size. After two unsuccessful attempts to build the foundations, three master builders were hired, Afonso Anjo, Gonçalo Anjo, and Rodrigues Anjo. With the help of several stonemasons, they managed to stabilize the foundations of the church and build the chancel and the main walls. The terrain's instability later caused cracks in the main portal and on the side of the building, leading to the construction of five flying buttresses on the southern side. One of those flying buttresses can still be seen in the southern face of the church, next to the building's side portal, here visible on the video. The side portal has four pointed archivolts with simpler capitals, and with the spaces between the columns decorated with fleur-de-lis symbols. After the 1755 earthquake, most of the church collapsed and the monastic area was severely damaged. The ensuing fire burnt most of its valuable contents. The reconstruction that began in the 18th century corresponds to an attempt to recreate the original Gothic style, an effort halted in 1834 by the extinction of the religious orders. The interior of the Carmo Church was divided into three naves with four bays. The apse had a chancel and four apse chapels. The space that now remains, where only the columns, part of the walls, and few restored arches remain, constitutes one of the most impactful reminders of the earthquake's effects. In 1864, the church's ruins were transferred to the Royal Association of Portuguese Architects and Archaeologists, an institution founded in the previous year. Joaquim Posidónio Narciso da Silva, president and main mentor of the association, projected the creation of a museum inside the ruins. Thus, many items are exhibited in the uncovered area that corresponds to the old church's nave, with the smaller, rarer, or more fragile pieces kept in the covered area in the church's apse. In the open area, we can see the Manueline tomb of the knight Main Cerveira from the 16th century that came from the São Bartolomeu chapel in the old convent of São Domingos in Santarém. In the transept area, several sculpted pieces that came from various civil and religious buildings are on display. Many of the items that integrate this museum's collection were retrieved after the abandonment or destruction of buildings throughout the country. The collection comprises portals, sections of altars, fountains, columns, tombstones, and other decorative and architectural elements from different eras. In the northern nave of the church, some stone objects are exhibited, including sections of columns, baptismal fonts, and heraldic sculpture. The 16th century baptismal font that came from Azamor in Morocco stands out. The outside is decorated with floral motifs, and inside there's a carved inscription. Over the doorway to the covered area of the museum, there's a beautiful limestone Manueline window from the first half of the 16th century that came from the Jerónimos Monastery in Lisbon. In the covered section of the museum that encompasses the old chancel and the four apse chapels, there are objects that span from the Paleolithic to the modern age. Room 1 displays items collected in archaeological excavations, with special emphasis on the objects that came from the Chalcolithic fortified settlement of Vila Nova de São Pedro in Azambuja. Room 2 features items like this Muslim ornamental plaque from the 10th, 11th century, or this Mozarabic frieze from the 9th, 10th century that came from the old convent in São Félix in Chelas, Lisbon. Another standout in this room is the sarcophagus of the Muses from the Roman era, 3rd to 4th century AD. That was found in Valado dos Frades, in the civil parish of Nazaré. These two Mozarabic pillar fragments, 9th or 10th centuries, came from the old convent of São Félix de Chelas, the left fragment, and from the Casa dos Bicos, the right fragment. In room 3, there's a medieval sculpture from the 13th or 14th century, made of marble, that came from the Alcácer d'Or in Santarém, depicting a king that has been identified as being Afonso I of Portugal. In the same room, we can find the tomb of Queen Constança Manuel from the 14th century, brought from Santarém, and the tomb of Friar Gonçalo de Souza from the 15th century, that came from the Convent of Christ in Tomar. One of the most remarkable pieces in this museum's collection is the tomb of King Ferdinand I of Portugal, sculpted in limestone between 1380 and 1382. This sarcophagus was originally placed in the choir of the San Francisco Convent in Santarém, and it was brought to this museum in 1875. This piece presents several mutilations that were caused by vandalism during the Napoleonic invasions and after the extinction of the religious orders in 1834. The tomb's lid is decorated with Portugal's coat of arms, featuring on one side the head of Christ and of the apostles Saint Peter and Saint Paul. On the other side, the king's figure is accompanied by a Christian and by a Muslim young man. Also in room 3, there's the tomb of Fernão Sanches, made in the first half of the 14th century and originating from the convent of São Domingos in Santarém. In room 4, there are several items from abroad, like this Egyptian sarcophagus and mummy from the 6th to 2nd century BC. In the same room, there are also two pre-Columbian mummies from the 16th century, belonging to the Chancay culture that developed in the central coastal area of Peru. In room 5, the highlight are these four alabaster plaques, sculpted in bas-relief in the 15th century in the famous Nottingham workshops. In the same room, there's a scale model depicting the Carmo Church as it was before the 1755 earthquake. Both for the beauty of the church's ruin and its exceptional collection, the Carmo Church and Museum deserve an attentive visit. Thank you for discovering Portugal with us. If you like the video, please click on the like button and subscribe to the channel to follow our new releases.